What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Fallout 4. We're in the Far Harbor DLC, or at least we're going to be getting into it very soon. First, I had to pop by Diamond City in order to pick up some ammunition, because we don't have any, like, at all. And as you can tell, we definitely need some. I don't even want to talk to you. Shut up. You're the lady with the ammo. Or you're not a... You're a dude. I'm sorry. Thinking safety, a long-range rifle. All right.
Maybe later. No problem.
Give me...
You know, a shotgun's great insurance against raiders.
Give me...
So you know,
no weapons? Blah, 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 blah.
Anyway...
Blah, 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 blah. Order.
Take a look. Self-defense.
Thank you. There we go. My inventory. His inventory. So we definitely need... We don't need 50 at all. We don't have any... We do have 308. We have plenty of 38. Plenty of 44. I'm going to buy some more. We don't need 44. Never mind. Tab cancel. 45 is definitely something we need. I'm just going to buy all of it. 5.56. Buy all of it. 5 millimeter. I think we have plenty of 5 millimeter, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, we have plenty of 5 millimeter. 5.56 is going to be quite important. 10 millimeter. Plenty of 10 millimeter. We have 308, 38, 44. We have pretty much everything we need. We don't need flares. We don't need any of that fancy stuff. We don't need any of this. Shotgun shells. Actually, I will take those. Let's just go to ammo. Here we are. Again, we have plenty of 5 mil, right? Yeah, we do. Plasma cartridge, railway spikes, 10 millimeter, plenty of 10 mil. Okay. Sounds about right for me. All right, we're good. We want to accept. There we go. Now we have 319 shots for my favorite gun in the game, which is the semi-automatic rifle. And now we need to pop on the radio, but in order for me to pop on the radio, I have to turn up the radio. Oh, we actually have it turned up. I've had copyright strikes in the past for radio stations, so I've always been pretty cautious about it. And now if we just go ahead and go into radio, we should have the radio frequency, unless we've already... I already walked into Valentine's shop, and that might actually be the starting of the quest. So, we might be there. Far From Home should be the first quest for Far Harbor. Far Harbor, Far From Home. And I believe you started in Valentine's shop, so we're going to pop in. Also, if you don't have this quest yet and you just started Fallout 4, you actually have to beat to a certain point in your mission in order for it to go, so.
Who's our client?
A fisherman. Whose family lives on the edge of the Commonwealth. Kenji Nakano.
Nakano? Huh. That name takes me back. My memory's a little fuzzy on the details, though.
Maybe if you bothered writing things down, Nick.
Can't do that. Wouldn't want to put you out of a job.
Huh. I'll remember that the next time you need me to console a hysterical client. Mr. Nakano didn't leave many details. Said he'd go over everything when you meet him. But if you want my guess... Missing person case. Guy had a worried look a mile long.
Anything you can tell me about Kenji Nakano?
Just some impressions. He was obviously upset, but he was also in a hurry. Like, he couldn't stand just waiting around. I'm a friend of Nick's. He'll remember me. I need his help right away. And then he was gone. He was muttering something on the way out, but... No. I'm not sure it was important.
Come on, Ellie. Don't hold out on me. What did he say?
No. No, I can't remember clearly. Don't want to taint the investigation before it's even started.
I'll go check it out. Thanks, Ellie.
The Nakano residence is up in the northeast, near the coast. A small fishing house. He said that he and his wife will be waiting for you.
It's a long walk. That's how the hard cases always start.
Shoot you right in the head for that statement. I don't like walking. Was that a fat joke? Huh? Bitch. Well, in case you guys haven't read the title yet, this is going to be the first hour of the DLC. So, I'd pause it right here and go grab some popcorn because we're going to be playing for quite a while. And it should be damn fun, honestly. I'm looking forward to this DLC. It's going to be a lot longer than the Automatron DLC. The Automatron DLC, honestly, I don't even count as DLC. It was kind of just like a random extra couple hours of gameplay more than it was DLC to kind of keep us on edge. Because that, I personally beat that DLC only a month ago. So it's pretty quick that this one just popped out. Well, not really out of nowhere. It was already planned, but that it popped up and everybody's ready to go. It's a good thing I've actually been to the Museum of Witchcraft and I've actually killed the Deathclaw that's there. Oh, I've been there. Oh, I actually remember. I went there and I made a video and it didn't save. And then I remember now. So we're going to fast travel to Gibson Point Pier and then we'll make our way up to the Nakano residence. So here we go. I'm more looking forward to this DLC because it's going to be very reminiscent of the other DLC from Fallout 3. Personally, I played through the regular missions in Fallout 3, but I never got around to the DLC. But back in the day, I used to watch my brother pretty much play all the games, mainly because we only owned like one console or one PC that was available to play on. And him being the older brother, obviously, he had priority over me. And eventually, things went my way, and I ended up getting like my own PC for Christmas and all this kind of stuff. So I never really got around to Fallout 3 DLC. We're also keeping Ada with us from the Automatron DLC. She's got some crazy ass guns going. I do miss Doge Meat very much, but it is what it is. I do not want to deal with Mire Lurks, but the thing is, I'm almost certain this entire DLC is based on Mire Lurks, so it's going to be pretty freaking annoying. But here we go, making our way downtown, walking fast, faces pass as I'm northbound, technically. And then we should 50 cal these guys. I am just potato aiming right now. And Ada is missing and dropping nukes. There you go, Ada. Good job, Ada. Some bottle caps. Why'd you have to shoot that? You just had to shoot the car. Just had to make it action-packed with explosions, didn't you, Ada? Just had to. I remember this. We had to climb the car to get across. Not too shabby. I think I was, if I remember correctly, I wasn't able to actually do this, and I had to swim. Yeah. Well, hopefully, Ada, you can do the same. Cannonball! And we're across the water. Hopefully, Ada just figures it out. And if I remember correctly, my anti-rads are negative. Yep, there we go. Boom. And then I believe zero was my stim packs, which is a terrible key for stim packs, but it was the default key, so I left it at that. I think it was the default key. I don't even remember. Hello? You know, it's just 50 cal a rad roach. Jesus, that took forever. I have so much 50 cal ammo, I shouldn't really even care. We're not going to stop at anything. We're pretty much just going to do the DLC. We're not going to be doing any other extra quests along the way. We're going to get to the DLC. We're going to do the DLC. And then if you guys enjoy, then we'll continue. If you guys want to see more of this even more often, I would leave a like on the video. The more likes I get, the more I know that you guys are looking forward to the next episode of the series. And if you guys don't leave likes, then I kind of just get upset with myself and feel like I'm wasting my time. But at the same time, I'll still be beating the DLC for sure. Really? Is there a generator here? Huh. It's kind of weird. I bet I could read the journal and find some stuff out, but this is not the DLC, so I don't want to do it. So much stuff I haven't explored. Oh. See you later, bitch. 50 cal to the throat. You ain't getting up after that. Nobody even knows I'm here. I'm a sneaky ninja with a 50. I feel like that needs to be like fan art. A ninja with a 50 cal. I probably would just Google that and it would be there, to be honest. It definitely exists somewhere. can't be the first person that's ever thought of that. Are we almost there? We're about halfway. A little more than halfway. We're not even following the road. We're just straight shotting it, so. Also, a lot of you guys, all you Fallout 4 aficionados out there. Ooh, I see a moon monkey. Wait, are you like a real person? No, I'm not dealing with that. I might steal his moon monkey, though. It might be required. Sorry. Stole your moon monkey. All you Fallout 4 aficionados out there are probably going to cringe in a lot of moments because I'm not the best at this game by any means. I believe I'm on normal, if I don't remember correctly. I wanted to do hardcore initially, but they only recently came out with, like, the quote-unquote hardcore patch that made it so you had to, like, eat and drink anyway. So, like, I never actually turned it on because it just made the game extremely difficult without even adding, like, anything really special. Ada, are you getting into a war up here? I also very rarely use VATs, mainly because I have good FPS and I have decent weapons and everything's just kind of easy if I, even if I don't use VATs. The only time I really use VATs is if I absolutely like need to take out multiple enemies within like a short period of time without dying. I had a lot of issues with the Mechanist Lair. I died multiple times in the episode where I was trying to actually get to the Mechanist boss, which was probably the most mediocre boss fight that I've ever had. I do remember the Myrler Queen. That was a fun one. But that was over at the castle in the earlier episodes doing the Minutemen side quests. If you guys didn't watch my original series, I actually went with the Institute, mainly because we've had the Brotherhood in the past, and we've kind of had the Minutemen with like just the Resistance in Fallout 3. So there really was no need in my brain to... Since the Institute was new, I didn't feel like I should like do anything besides the Institute. So I'm trying to find out where this is. They said it was a boat or something. So I'm just assuming the coast is where we need to be. Oh god, there's a glowing ghoul right there. We need to be careful. And we got ghouls. But my semi-automatic weapon is quite the strong one. Semi-automatic rifle. What are you shooting at, Ada? Oh, Ada got him. We're good. Please don't shoot at the glowing one. I don't want to deal with that, especially if it mutates. Can I jump over this fence again? I had no problem the first time. There we go. Alright, so I think it's right over here. This is definitely like a fishing dock of some sort. With a voice crack. Hello. Some floaties. Some flotation devices. Oh, this looks promising. I'm like off the map now. Can't even see where I'm going. What's this in the steel box? Ooh.
That's it.
Ammo. I've always needed ammo. Also, I should probably favorite my shotgun. I think I took it off my favorites. I have this never-ending pipe pistol that does pretty well for spamming. But if I remember correctly, it uses the same ammo as my semi, but it's never-ending, so it can just spam like crazy. Shotgun ammo I don't have much of, but I do have a good amount. He has a carrot in his cooler. All right. And I still wish I could find a never-ending semi-automatic rifle. That would be absolutely amazing. But I don't really have to reload the semi-automatic weapon too often anyway, because it's 20 shots and it does a shit ton of damage. We're finally here.
Come in! What? I know you're listening on the other end. Where is she? Where is my daughter?
Kenji, please. You've been at this for hours. Stop. You need...
What? Who are you? I'm sorry, but we don't have time for visitors or caravans or wherever you're from.
You were shouting about a missing daughter. What happened?
A good Samaritan? Fine. I'm out of options anyway, if you want to hear about it. My daughter is missing. It all started with this damn radio.
Our daughter Kasumi likes to fix things. The radio was her latest project.
Until she made contact with some kidnapper who lured her away from us.
Or maybe she left on her own. She's not a child anymore. Our daughter is 19. She knows how to survive, and she's capable. I think maybe she left because she wanted her own life.
No. She would have told us where she was going. She would have said something. I know my daughter is in danger. I can feel it. Find her, please.
Let's talk money. Investigations for the missing aren't cheap.
I am not going to barter over my daughter's life. Your fee is going to be 300 caps. Take it or leave it.
Do you have any idea where she could have gone?
We know she took one of the boats, but that's all. She could be anywhere.
I'll find her. Don't you worry.
Thank you. Her room is upstairs, if that helps. And if you had any more questions about her, just ask.
Her room's upstairs. She likes to tinker with stuff. And she made a radio. So she definitely like radioed into Far Harbor, not knowing that even people like existed over there. And she decided to like go check it out or something. Maybe she was just curious, or maybe she met a boy. There's usually, you know, 19-year-old girl gets on the radio, boy picks up on the other end, you know, sending nudes through Morse code, you know, normal stuff. Back in the day, that's how they used to do it. October 2077. All right, we're gonna go peep her room out. Very creepy. Like, I think this is not her room at all, but I'm gonna take everything that they have. Wow, look at this comfy bed. Nice TV. Screwdriver. Kasumi's product lamp. Or project lamp. So she made this lamp. That's pretty cool. Nice little bathroom. And I think this is her room. Yep, this looks like a tinkerer's room. Duct tape. I'll take that for the everything. Duct tape. And she was tinkering with some stuff. Nice little toy rocket ship.
Alco Sales and Service seems the perfect innocuous place for a military installation.
Shut up. Just a chair. Whole bunch of random shit. Wonder glue. Globe. A bed. A kitty cat. And a hole in the roof. That's normal, probably. I'm not really sure. There's nothing in here that I need to investigate, so I assume I just need to talk to them a little bit more. Oh, is that the radio on the ground? No, it's just a toolbox that I already looted. Talk to them a little bit.
Mrs. Nakano.
I suppose you have questions about my daughter.
Tell me more about this radio your daughter was working on.
I remember Kasumi was very excited about it. I figured she was secretly trying to make contact with Diamond City or another settlement. We're pretty isolated out here. She only has us for company, and Kenji can be overprotective.
You and your husband don't seem to agree about why your daughter left.
We both want to find her. The world out there isn't a place where you want to be alone. But Kenji still sees her swaddled in diapers. He doesn't see a young woman with her own decisions to make. Maybe because it's more frightening. She wasn't tricked into leaving without telling us. That was her choice. She didn't want us to follow. Why?
I'd like to know more about Kasumi. Might shine a light on where she's gone.
My daughter is strong, focused, careful. That's how I know she's still alive. But why would she leave without telling us? Maybe we... No, never mind. I don't want to waste your time.
Every detail is important, Mrs. Nakano. Don't hold back.
No, it's nothing. I don't want to distract the detective.
Nothing else right now.
Wish I had more up in speech. I'd get more
Mr. Nakano,
talking.
Did you have questions about my daughter?
Why did your daughter really leave? Your wife says she left on her own, but you said it was kidnappers.
I know it was kidnappers. Kasumi is a smart girl, but she doesn't know how horrible people can be. Not like me and Ray. Why would she just leave her family with no explanation? Someone tricked her, got her to leave the safety of home. Every minute we aren't looking for my daughter, her life is in jeopardy.
Tell me more about this radio she was fixing.
I've tried to get that damn thing to work over and over again, but there's nothing. I thought she just wanted to strip it for parts or build a toaster out of it or something, like she usually does. Someone made contact with her, and then they took her. God, what kind of twisted psychopath has my daughter?
Anything more you can tell me about Kasumi? The smallest detail could be important.
I don't know what more to say. She's my little girl, and she doesn't know how dangerous this world is. I never should have let her grandfather teach her how to fix these machines.
Her grandfather? He taught her how to fix the radio?
Ever since she was old enough to walk, yes. Her grandfather had an ear for machines. Kasumi picked up the knack. He passed away recently. He used to scavenge the ruins in the south for parts. I kept telling him he was getting too old.
No more questions.
So we're going to have to put together a radio.
Work quickly, detective.
It's the way I look at it. Okay. Really nothing left. Do we have anything to go off of at all? Investigate the Nakano residence. So there's got to be something in her room, right? It's the only thing I can think of. Is this a bong? Table lamp, close enough. Probably make a bong out of it. Doesn't seem to be anything, though. Her bed. Oh, what's this? Oh, we should listen to her projects. Let's do that. We should have radio. Or is it workshop stats, inventory, miscellaneous, right?
Project log, dreams. Recording what I can remember when I wake up. I keep having the same one. I'm in a white room. People are talking about me like I'm not there, or maybe they just don't care. And then there's this, I don't know, jolt, like a spark of electricity to the back of my head, and then everyone turns to look at me. God, I hope I don't have it again tonight.
Okay, so she had a bad dream about a white room and a jolt.
Project log. Lamp. Filament plus power equals light. I swear, sometimes I think my parents break these things just to keep me busy.
Okay, so we need to find more of those. Oh. Heard the dir. Here's the radio project one. This is going to tell me where she is.
Project log? Radio. Correction. Working radio. I'll finally get some news outside this house. My handle is going to be... Let's go with Ohm's Law. That should confuse the creeps. And if someone actually gets the reference, then we'll at least have circuitry in common.
Okay, that didn't explain anything to me at all. We need to find more of those tapes. If we can. Because one of those tapes is going to tell me exactly what I need to know. Guarantee it. Alright, let's check around the outside. Ooh, there's actually a barn out there. So this is like some real investigative stuff, man. This is like a boathouse or a barn or something. There's bound to be like a tape in here, I bet, right? All these different machines and stuff. Battered clipboards. Duct tape, always. Picture frame, fusion cells, 50 caliber bullets. If you ever get locked to the safe, the answer is here in the boathouse. Picture where the key is.
Find anything useful?
Picture where the key is. What? Does that even make sense? Well, I have expert lockpicking, so who the hell cares?
Sweet.
There it is. Here's our final note. Where is it? Kasumi? Oh, there it is.
Project log? Myself. I never really thought about who or what I am, but... God. Where do I start? The radio. I was right about the range. I managed to get a signal, a strong signal, from up north. There's a group of people up there. They say they're all synths. Synthetic people, made by the Institute. They are trying to build a place for their kind, where they can be themselves and be accepted for what they are alongside human beings. It sounds wonderful, but then they started asking about me, and some questions came up. Questions I don't have answers to. I mean, I've always felt off, like I'm not really supposed to be here, but then... There are things in my childhood I can't remember, and I've been having strange dreams.
She's a synth.
I'm going to go to meet these synths.
Kitty.
I have Hello, to Kitty. Know the truth. They've told me to sail up north to a town called Far Harbor. I can make my way to them from there.
Hello, Kitty.
I don't like cats. So she's a synth. That's what she left out. She's a fucking synth. And rip cats. Let's go see what the next thing on the quest line is. Talk to Kenji Nakano. Hello, Kenji.
Excuse me, synth. Mr. Nakano.
Have you finished your investigation? Did you find anything?
I need to ask you an important question. Are you sure... Your daughter is human.
What kind of question is that? Why are you asking?
Your daughter made contact with a group of synths. She thinks she's one of them.
What? That's crazy.
She's not a synth. She's our daughter. We raised her. I gave birth to her.
Lying sack of shit.
She's flesh and blood, not a synthetic.
That's how synths work, Mrs. Nakano. They replace people. This could have happened recently.
I know my own daughter. She's not a synth.
This is what I was afraid of. Someone twisting my daughter's mind. Did you find where Kasumi went, Detective?
I think Kasumi took off somewhere up north. Do you know what's up there?
Where specifically? I've been up the coast, almost to where the waters start to freeze, but that's a lot of miles.
I think I know where Kasumi went. A place called Far Harbor?
She went that far up north? God, that explains why she took the boat. You have to go after her. Please, take my other ship on the dock outside. My father's design. It has a guidance system, and it is built for distance.
What can I expect out there, Kenji?
I only made the trip to Far Harbor once, when I was a boy. All I remember is that my father did not want to stay long. Something about the air being bad.
I'll get to the bottom of this, Kenji.
Thank you. And here, the payment we discussed. I'll have something more when Kasumi is safely back home.
Yeah, well, you know how much I spent on ammo,
Excuse
motherfucker?
Excuse me, Mrs. Nakano.
My daughter is human. She's not a synth.
She's a goddamn synth, and you know it, alright? Stop lying to yourself and me. I killed your cats, and now I'm stealing your boat. Have a nice day. Let's definitely quick save real quick, because it has been a while since I've quick saved. Travel to Far Harbor. Here we go. Why is it going backwards? I think your grandfather built the boat wrong. Okay, it's turning. I don't even have to steer. I'll see you later, Ada. Ada's not even on the boat with me. This is a magical ship of destiny. How long does it take? I hope it just like fast travels me, kind of. Hope, imagine if it's just like 1 hour later, literally. Okay, good, it's fading out. I killed their cats. I kind of feel bad. I assume that they're the child's cats because she had some cat pictures in her room. How did the cats survive, like, the nuclear bombings? How is that even possible? That's, like, a lot of freaking cats. Like, that to survive, too? I'm surprised they didn't become mutant cats. Imagine a mutant cat? Sounds awful. Alright, where are we going? We have to almost be there. There's a house right there. Do we have a map of Far Harbor? Oh my lord, Far Harbor is massive! Holy shit! Okay. I mean, sure. This is a big DLC. I heard it was 30 to 40 hours plus of extra content. By no means are we going to do all of it. We're probably going to follow the main storyline in this series, and if you guys do show your support as much as possible in the series, we might do some side quests, but I do see myself maybe streaming this in the future. Put the damn gun down. I'm here, far from home.
Are you lost? This is Far Harbor. We don't get many visitors around here.
We don't need no freeloaders or more help, Mainlander. So you can get back in your boat and leave.
Alan, this isn't your dock. It belongs to the whole town. And that means strangers are welcome. Sorry, you've caught us during a difficult time. But Alan's got a point. Not all visitors have good intentions. So, what's your business here?
What is this place?
Well, in ancient times, this used to be a tourist town. My people have lived here and on the island for generations. But now everyone's crowded onto the docks just trying to survive another day. We have more than our fair share of problems. You aren't here to add to them, are you?
I need information about a synth refuge on this island.
Ah, another Commonwealth traveler looking for Acadia, then.
Hello.
Damn it. Mariner's incoming.
Something's coming through the fog!
You, what? Help us defend what? The town, and I'll answer any questions you have. Take a post at the top of the wall near the main gate.
What?
The hall never lets us down. Now follow me!
What?
Careful on the hall, stranger. Don't fall off.
What's happening?
You, we might not be able to rescue you in time.
Follow Captain Avery? Okay. Right here? What's coming? I hope it's not Mirelurks. I hate Mirelurks.
In the hall. Something's out there.
What is this? I also need to turn up voice. Wow, voice audio is all the way up. Let's turn it up in general then, huh?
You sure you saw something?
This ain't a drill.
What's out there?
What the hell?
Is it
healed, everyone.
A Deathclaw?
Time. Look to the fog. They're coming.
Oh my god, they're throwing grenades like crazy. Young gulpers? What the hell are gulpers? Mutant fish? Oh my lord. These things are ugly. They're like naked Barneys.
I lost them.
Alright, are they all dead?
Hunters, look out!
Hunters? What the fuck are hunters? Good? We're good?
No. Eyes on the fog. Something's coming.
Deathclaw. Whoa, they have ranged attacks. Holy crap. Is that it? Or do we have even more?
We're clear.
That bitch just jumped off. I can finally talk to this bitch.
Avery.
And now you see what we're up against.
Those things weren't that hard.
The creatures it spits out have taken the whole island from my people. But for your help when we needed it, you deserve this.
Well, you paid as much as the frickin' dad did.
What's the fog?
Where to begin? The fog's radioactive, right? But there are pockets of it. The deep fog. that are hard fallout. And as deadly as that is, that's only part of the problem. Things live in the fog, thrive. You think what attacked the harbor's bad? Oh, there's far worse further inland.
Everywhere I go, nobody's got it easy.
No argument here. I think...
I'm done cowering behind your damn hull, Avery. Time you let me deal with the real problem. With the right people and my guns, I can end those Children of Adam cultists for good.
The fog's been here forever. The children didn't make it.
Before the Rat Eaters came, the fog was under control. They come, and it all goes wrong. It's time we do something.
No need to burden the stranger with all this nonsense.
Can we get back to business?
Sorry for all that. You're headed for Acadia, right? Getting there will be dangerous. You'll need a guide. Old Longfellow. No one knows the fog like him. But word of warning, he's a bit of an acquired taste.
Thanks for the info.
Best place to look for Longfellow's at the bar. The last plank. And, please, lend a hand around town if you're able. Even if it's slapped away, people like the Mariner and Cassie and others need help. And let me say something you might not hear again. Thank you.
Yeah, she's like, do my bidding for me, heathen. And I'm just like, no, bitch. All right, we need to go find old Longfellow. Well, that was easy.
Mariner.
The hull took a battering, to be sure. But she wouldn't be standing at all if it weren't for you. They call me the Mariner, shipwright, handyman, the only one keeping the harbor afloat. Well, beside Captain Avery.
A pleasure to meet you.
Likewise. I hope the island doesn't kill you quick. Or slow, for that matter. I don't suppose you'd be willing to lend a hand. In order to do proper repairs, I need tools. Specialized tools. And they won't be easy to come by. 450 caps if you can, though.
So I'd be risking my life for only 450 caps.
The pay is what the pay is. Are you in or out?
Sign me up. I'll help.
Eagle's Cove Tannery. Tools are certain to be there. Now get.
Alright, that's one of the optional missions that I'm going to do later. We're going to continue with the main mission as much as possible, like I said. Walk in the park. So he's over here in the bar. The Last Plank. Nice bar name. Probably is the last plank. Is there actually a plank to walk on is the question. So they're all living on the boats due to this radiated fog. I'm curious what's upstairs. What?
We're trying to have a conversation here.
Shut your mouths. Open your damn ears.
Bar in town.
So the fogs are coming for us all. And I can't see any better way of greeting it than to have another round. On the house.
Yeah!
Time to party.
Here's some Mitch.
All right. None of that. One second. I have a feeling that since I turned on the jukebox, the radio is about to play, and we're not about to get copyright striked on an hour-long video.
Captain Avery said you can get me to Acadia.
Heard there was a scuffle out there. You get your hands dirty? I'm done leading people to their deaths in the fog. Last fella couldn't keep up. Didn't last 5 minutes.
Can you tell me about Acadia?
Strange folk like there. Call themselves synths. Seems to me they just want to be left alone, to live their life in peace. They've done some good turns for us islanders. The fog condensers, most especially, wouldn't even be a Far Harbor left without those.
What's a fog condenser?
The condensers? They're a tricky bit of science. They keep the fog away. Powered by the wind farm, the synth fellows got up and running. Us islanders don't particularly like being obligated to them. But there you have it.
I'm not some no-name mainlander. I'm tough enough for your little island.
Sling a bit of lead on the hull, and now you think you're ready to walk in the fog, do you? Things you'll see inland make that look like a Sunday stroll.
I helped the harbor out. I figure all of you owe me something at least.
If you're looking to square away some debt with the harbor, then you can get in line behind me. Listen, if you're dead set on this foolishness, get me a bottle of whiskey from the bartender, Mitch. Until then, we're done.
All right. I'll get you some whiskey.
Mainlander, today's your lucky day. Free beer for ya. Ha ha!
You have anything a bit stronger?
Ha ha! I like your style, but... No. So, drink up! You stay here over long and the fog will claim you. Might as well meet her with a belly full of fire, eh?
I could use a drink.
Now that's what I like to hear, ha!
And he wanted what? What did he want again? Whiskey. Let's get him... Let's get him a whiskey, huh? There we go. And accept. Nice and easy. Got a whiskey.
Don't like the service.
Excuse me.
You got my whiskey yet?
Here you go.
Ah, now you're talking. I can get you to Acadia, but you've got to listen to me. Go where I say, when I say it. Still won't be easy. You stock up on your necessities, Rad-X and the like, and then the real work can begin.
Should I make any other preparations?
Ammo, stimpaks, maybe a rocket or three. Worse than Meyer lurks out there.
Let's go, Longfellow.
Follow me, then.
Here we go, Longfellow. 20 more minutes in the episode and see how far we can get with Longfellow. I'm wondering how far we can get in 20 minutes. I know, like I said, it's 30 to 40 hours of content. I don't know how long the main mission in Far Harbor is, but I'm just assuming it's definitely not an hour long.
It's above the fog line on the mountain. It's a bit of a hike. You might want to take this for the road. Case foul.
The children of Adam are dangerous.
But it'll help.
Don't trust him. I lost my home.
Myler jerky. Alright, so he's telling me to eat the Mirelurk jerky. I'm down to eat it.
Old mountain trail is where we're.
So Ada can come with. That's pretty cool.
Ain't like nothing you've seen in Commonwealth. Mainlanders think a dose of Radaway is all you need. Tracks. Fresh ones. Trappers ahead. When the bullets start flying, find cover. Keep your head down if you want to live.
This ain't my first walk or my first rodeo, okay? You hear? If anything, you should put your head down because I'm going to be tapping these fools. Did I just get shot from behind? I think Ada just shot me. Ooh, if I can hit this... 5% on the left arm. Nope. I see him though. I've hit him a couple of times. Hello. Easy. Pull out the semi again. Is there a guy on the roof? Yeah, there's a guy on the roof. There's the angle. Come on, peek again. There we go. Easy headshot. Alright. Shotgun. Coastal armor? I'm just curious. As to if it's better. I don't think anything's really going to be much better than what we have right now. Mechanist armor? Is that actually better than what I have? So I'm at 77.51. This is 72.72. So we're actually better off with that. We're at 86.80 now. Alright, so we're going to drop a lot of shit if we need to. So now we're in the mechanist armor. Alright. Is he trying to talk to us?
Bad in a scrap. Figured I'd have to take care of a lot of them. I just make a
Alright.
See, the fog can do a number. Get you off the train.
Military cap, bobby pin pack.
Rappers were mean to begin with, but now...
Should be pretty easy with the semi-automatic rifle that I got. This thing packs a damn punch. Random, like, trolley-looking boat over there? That's pretty cool. I like the atmosphere. I do like the fog. Kind of reminds me of the old zombies days on Call of Duty. Nope, we missed, but we headshotted the Reaver. Oh my god, there's a lot of ghouls, huh? Is there any other? No, nothing else to attack. That was a good amount of ghouls that came out of nowhere. I assume it's going to get harder. I hope it does. Quite the simple situation right now. Ooh. I like lockpicking some stuff. That's why I have expert lockpicking.
Yes.
Thank you. I wish I could pick stuff up like this and bring it back. And put it inside my house and stuff. Over in Sanctuary. Alright, I must have some huge amount of junk that I should just drop. Amount of duct tape that I have. It only weighs 0.1 though. That weighs a lot. Sorry, Jangles, I have two of them. Nuka-Cola bottle. And then armor-wise, we really don't need any of this anymore because the mechanist armor is better.
You're dropping that? Strange. It seems quite useful to me.
Oh, hello. Didn't even notice you were alive. I'm just generally quite curious. Like, this boat is here. There's bound to be some loot seas on it. I got a little bit of ammo, which is already more than worth it just for coming up here. Ammo's gonna get quite scarce as we move around. Alright, let's keep on trucking.
Deep fog has all manner of nasties. Here's the mountain trail. If you stick to this, it'll make it to Acadia. Game trails crisscross the road, so don't be surprised if we got local wildlife to deal with.
Local wildlife? Why do I feel like we're gonna hit a deathclaw?
We ain't alone.
Alright, the wolves are a bit stronger than the ghouls. I think we're good.
You like them puppies?
Don't call them puppies. Makes me feel awful because I just killed puppies.
Still got a ways to go.
Jesus, this lens flare, huh?
We steer clear, but you never know.
I'd rather not deal with whatever roared.
No higher than your knee. Whole island was covered in fog. The fog eventually rolled back. People resettled, but they got comfortable. Started taking things for granted. Folk got short memories. All this has happened before.
All right. At least we got the wise man leading us in. Actually knows what he's talking about and knows what he's doing.
What was that?
Okay, so the Mirelurks are getting attacked by these gulpers. That's pretty cool. Like kind of fighting each other. So even though they're in the water, we still kind of have to shoot them. Just because they're aggroed. There we go. I do like my third person every once in a while. Especially when you just got this dot. And you don't have the bad field of view as like, as something like this.
Gulper's got a fondness for fresh water. Small gulper, the ones in these parts, is a fair challenge. Now the big one. They can grow 2-3 times the size of a man.
I don't want to deal with those. Oh, hello, ghouls. That wasn't too hard. Should have saw it coming, though. Let's keep on trucking, buddy. Should be almost there to Acadia, which is a type of water. This entire Far Harbor DLC is one big advertisement for water. Oh, peaceful music. Does that mean we're almost there? Oh, hello.
Stringing one more soul to the damnation, old man?
Well, what have we here? Another rat worshiping lunatic, that's what.
Your barbs do not harm me. I am shielded by my faith.
How about bullets? Faith shield you against those, too?
Who's she?
One of them children of Adam preachers. Started off as pests. Now they're more like a menace.
Do not sully this one with your blasphemy, old man. You. I suggest you go no further. Acadia is a nest of snakes. Beasts that subvert the will of Adam.
You do know you're crazy, right?
Watch yourself, outsider. You walk through Adam's kingdom now.
If you're done wasting time with a fanatic, let's move.
Yeah, I've already dealt with the children of Adam. I got the gamma gun from them. Clean. Wasn't very good.
Acadia's not too far now.
Oh, that's a dome. Do they live in a dome? Whoa. That's pretty cool.
And we've arrived. Acadia's already been watching us for a good spell. If you want to talk with them, just go inside. They'll be waiting for you. You need my help again. You come see me. Got a cabin just outside of Far Harbor. Good place to tool up your gear, get some rest, or get stinking drunk. Just make sure if you're bringing a bottle of something strong, there's enough to share.
You should come with me. I could still use your help.
All right. Why the hell not? Beats drinking alone.
Send Ada to the castle. Confirm. Fuck you, Ada. I want the new character in my life. Also got a really cool, like, Winchester-looking shotgun. See you later, Ada. Oh, we leveled up. Level 50. Or level 30. Not 50. Definitely 30. Alright, what do we want? What have we been going up in? Armorer. Locksmith. Rank 4 high-tech. We wanted to get something, like, down here, I thought. So, party boy, steady aim, hipfire is increased with every gun. That would be really dope, but I don't have enough strength for that yet. Ammunition in containers. Let's do ammunition in containers. I always have issues with ammunition. All right, let's go inside Acadia. I feel like this is going to be a disappointing place for some reason. I don't know. We'll see. It's inside a giant dome. So it better look cool. Or at least a part of it is inside a really big dome.
Don't have the key.
Hello?
You know, when I first climbed this mountain above the fog, I thought to myself, now here is a metaphor worth taking in.
You are creepy
you
as fuck, buddy.
Place of clarity, understanding, peace. While you're here in Acadia, Synthkind welcomes you as long as you welcome us.
Well, in that case, I want a Nuka-Cola, some stim packs, Kasumi Nakano returned to her family, and a pony.
I see. I'm afraid some of those things I'm not in a position to give. Kasumi is here. She's safe and unharmed, and you're free to see her if you'd like. Before you do, though, tell me, do you think Kasumi is a synth?
She is a synth. That's why she left home.
Kasumi had honest questions about herself. She came here for answers. None of us take this transition lightly. She's facing the possibility of her entire life being a lie. That someone stripped her very identity from her and made her into something she isn't. I want you to understand that before you see her. She has a chance here to live as a synth, not hiding, not pretending to be something else. One more question, if you'll indulge me. You're here for Kasumi, but I suspect there could be another reason you came to us. Tell me, are you a synth?
No, but if I squint real hard in the mirror, sometimes I look like someone else.
I'm afraid when I try that trick, nothing really changes. I know it might seem impossible that you could be a synth, but tell me, what's the first thing you can remember?
I remember being in my house the day the bombs fell. We ran to the vault. We were frozen. I was the only survivor.
No memories before then? Just a single day and then waking up alone? We so easily accept what's presented to us as the truth, don't we? Isn't it funny how a memory can feel like a whole different reality? People, places, even sounds and colors can change. Or someone else has changed them. I won't lie to you. There will always be other explanations. Trauma, disease, the background radiation. They all take their toll on the mind. But I can promise you that we will accept you, no matter what you decide you are.
I've heard enough. Where's Kasumi Nakano?
Of course. Kasumi is usually working down below. You can see her whenever you like. Acadia is open to you. Feel free to walk the grounds. Introduce yourself to my co-founders, Faraday and Chase. Did you need anything else before you go?
I'm just gonna tell you right now, Bima. I'm in the Institute.
That's quite an admission to make. I'm used to the Institute striking from the shadows. I'll say this to you. I'm not your enemy. I only wish to live here, in peace, with my people. As a scientist, can you not see the value of independent synth life? You have a chance here to witness how wondrous that could be. All you have to do is do nothing. Don't tell your fellow researchers about us. Don't tell them we're here.
Fine. I'll keep your secrets for now.
Thank you. Now, was there anything else I can do for you?
I should get going.
Of course.
Perhaps we're in there a long time. Are you feeling all right?
I'm fine. You worry too much.
Sometimes I feel like you don't worry enough. You know we blew 3 more relays this week. I'm coming in.
Where's Faraday?
You stay right there.
Confused. Well, thank you guys for stopping by the first hour of the new Fallout 4 Far Harbor DLC. We are here at Acadia, and we will be returning in the next episode, continuing on our quest in order to save the young little girl that was quote-unquote kidnapped. I hope that's a human and not a synth, or a synth and not a human, but I think they're all synths. I don't really know. Here's the dome. It's pretty awesome. Kind of looks like a broken Death Star with chunks out of it. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed. Leave a like if you did. And comment down below, potato, if you've made it this far. Just potato. And don't tell anybody why you commented potato. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a nice day.